is up, man? Tim Muriello here, fitness and supplement expert for I'llPumpYouUp.com. I've got in the studio the legendary superstar professional TNA wrestler Garrett Bischoff. What's up, man?
How you doing, bro? Good to see you.
Got this man in the studio. This dude, now listen, this guy's hard to catch. So I hope you're very grateful that I got this guy. He's on the road, he's on TV all over the nation, touring all over the place, wrestling who knows who all over the place. So we finally nailed him down, got him in the studio. Garrett, we want to do a video with our viewers. We want to talk about, first off, what's it take to be a pro wrestler, the life of a pro wrestler, how do you eat as a pro wrestler, just the life of a pro wrestler and still trying to maintain a good physique and all that stuff. Tell us real quickly, man, how did you get started in wrestling?
I got started out in Burbank, California, actually.
Okay.
School of Hard Knocks out there. It's Rikishi and Gangrel and the Black Pearl. Those were the guys that got me started and broke me into the business. After that, I came down here to Tampa, Florida. Went over to the Nastyville School of Pro Wrestling with old Brian Knobs himself. What a rush that was, I'll tell you what. And after
the
that,
Brian Knobs, he was one of the Nasty Boys.
Nasty
right?
Boys.
Oh, all right, yeah.
The blonde one.
Oh, yeah, yeah, okay, yeah.
The one that has all his teeth, not the other one. But, those are the guys that really took care of me and put me in training school and broke me in the right way. And the rest is history, you know?
Yeah, that's so awesome, man. What does it take, man? I mean, I have so many personal friends that are trying to be pro wrestlers. Everywhere, man, all over the United States, dudes are trying to become, women too, trying to become professional wrestlers. Just quick snapshot, man, what does it freaking take to make the big times, man? Get into TNA wrestling, WWE, things like that. What does it take, man? Is it a special formula? Is it a certain look? I mean, what is it, man?
Honestly, at the end of the day, it takes heart and it takes determination, because it can be a long, long, brutal, hard road before you get anywhere.
Yeah.
Some guys do this their entire lives and never make it, never make it in there. So at the end of the day, that's what it really is. It's hard determination and the will just to never give up and keep going.
Yeah.
Then you got everything else that goes along with it, and that's the training. You know, you put your body through a hell of a beating. You know,
yeah.
Some people just can't take that. There's a million things that go along with it, but at the end of the day, that's the
just
big,
that hard
that's
work, man. You gotta keep plugging at it and trucking,
it.
And
that's right.
That's how you're gonna get found and get up there. So how is it, man? I mean, you're wrestling. How many? You know, when you're trying to become pro, obviously you're doing a lot of wrestling matches. You're doing a lot of training and stuff like that. How the heck do you juggle bodybuilding, doing a weight training regimen? You're trying to build your muscles. You're trying to stay lean. Is trying to put on some size and wrestle at the same time.
You know, it comes down to you just got to be determined. You got to get yourself in there. It's the mornings when you wake up, and after you've been on the road for 4 or 5 days and you're getting beat up night in and night out, the last thing you want to do is get up and go lift weights and hit the gym and hit that cardio. But
yeah, your body's freaking jacked,
you
man.
You got to force yourself to do it. Got to stick in there. When we're on the road, we like to find the mom and pop gyms in all the towns we go to. Those are the, fun ones to go to. Those are the ones where we always have the best weights. We have the best.
Yeah, you can scream. You can do whatever you want. You don't have to worry about lurk alarms going off and stuff like that.
Absolutely.
That's tight, man.
That's our favorite thing to do. We find the mom and pop gyms, and we'll ask around, and usually they're always willing to take care of us and hook us up, and we'll send some pictures and take some pictures in the mom and pop gyms, and those are the fun ones.
Yeah, that's killer, man. That'd be awesome. Did they charge you?
Nah, usually they hook us up.
Hook you up. I'm like, yeah, come on free, take a couple pictures.
We don't mind paying, but usually they hook us up.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. What's it like being on the road, man, and trying to eat right, eat clean? Obviously, you got a physique that's in front of countless who knows how many people on TV. They're seeing you live in person. You got to be lean. You got to still be full, plenty of muscle. How do you eat like a bodybuilder but traveling all the dang time, man?
When we're on the road, Cracker Barrel and IHOP are our two best friends.
Oh my gosh.
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner, that's where we're at.
Dude, I cannot stand Cracker Barrel, man. Now, IHOP, I love IHOP, but dang.
Oh, that's our spot. You can get everything in there. You get breakfast all day, you get steak, you get eggs, you get biscuits and gravy. Not that we need to eat biscuits and gravy a lot, but
yeah, you gotta get it in, man.
Gotta get a little good stuff in there.
That's right. Now, your workouts, do they ever tell you, I mean, like, they don't want you to get too big when it comes to wrestling, or they just want you to, they don't mind you getting a little too big, obviously.
Nah, I mean, it's each their own. It's everybody else, every man for himself out there, as far, it's up to you what you want to look like, and, if there's something really going overboard, someone might say something to you and, have a better idea to change it up, depending on what's going on, but for the most part, it's up to us to.
Up to you.
Keep our physique and do what we're going to do with it.
Yeah, yeah. Is there a lot of pressure in professional wrestling, man, where they're
absolutely,
where they're just like, you know, hey, man, you're gaining a little too much weight, or absolutely, dude, we seen your last show, your abs look like crap. I mean, what's sure, the pressure like with your physique?
Absolutely. If you start getting a little soft around the midsection, they better, you better believe something.
Oh, out, man.
Hey, brother.
Yeah, you need some help, man. What, so when your workouts, what are your workouts like right now? Are you still trying to go heavy, hard? Are you still just trying to get huge? Or
I try to change it up, keep it, you know, keep that happy medium.
Yeah.
So I like to go for a month where I just go heavy and I hit it as hard as I can, just all the way to the wall, put that size and that mass on.
Yeah.
But then I like to change it up. Keeps the body from hitting that plateau, you know? So then I'll, maybe the next month, all my workouts are the lightweight with the heavier or the higher reps.
Yeah, yeah.
That way, just kind of burn it up and keep the definition, keep the cuts going on.
Yeah, absolutely, low rest. What about for endurance? Is there certain types of exercises that you have to do to like maintain your endurance for the ring, or?
I'll tell you, I do my cardio every day. However, there is
What do you typically do when it comes to cardio?
I do about 20, 30 minutes just on a either elliptical or a treadmill on a big incline.
Just kind of a maintain.
Yeah, just to maintain, just to kind of keep the fat burning. But there is no kind of training you can do other than being in that ring when it comes to that kind of endurance. You can run on a treadmill, you can run on a 5K all you want, but it's not the same.
Nothing's going to replicate being in a ring, beating the crap out of each other.
Get out there and do it.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, who right now in TNA wrestling is the champ, man? Who's got the freaking belt?
Right now, Magnus.
Magnus.
Yep.
Oh, when are they finally gonna give you the belt, man? You need to talk to some people. Like, look, man, I need this freaking belt. I paid my dues, man. Let me get this belt.
You never know.
Never know. How bad do you want that belt, man?
All I know is Magnus better watch out, because you got my eye on you. I'm coming.
Okay. All right. Right on. You can talk a little smack here, a little wrestling smack on our video. So what? How? When it comes to wrestling, have you had a lot of injuries in professional wrestling?
I've been fortunate to not have too many injuries. Concussions. I've had a few of them.
You've had a couple concussions.
Couple concussions. Yep. Busted a rib, but nothing too crazy. Nothing that's.
What about this? Has anybody ever hit you too hard? I know they hit you hard, but
they
I'm talking like
time I'm in there.
Too like out of the ordinary, like, oh crap, bro, you just freaking hit me, and that was like non-scheduled.
That's how do you think I got my concussion?
What happened, man?
I was coming off the ropes. I was with AJ Styles in the ring, coming off the ropes, and he, you know, it happens. He clocked me hard, hit the hell out of me, and put me right out there.
Dang, you were knocked out?
Anybody wants to say that this stuff's fake, I dare you to step in there with me. It hurts.
Yeah, big time. So you got knocked out, you're laying in the ring.
Knocked out.
In the ring. Dang, was it televised?
Yeah, it's on live TV.
Live TV, you're sitting there freaking knocked out. Jeez, that's
people
crazy.
People say this stuff's fake.
How long can you do it for, though? You know what I'm saying? Do what, 35? I mean, there's got to come a point where you're like, dude, your body just can't take professional wrestling anymore.
You know, everybody's different. It just all kind of depends. I mean, look at guys like Ric Flair and Hulk Hogan. I mean, bless them. Up until a year ago, they're still in the ring, doing stuff.
Yeah, and they're in their, like, what, 50s or 60s or something?
Those guys are legends, and so you just never know. It just kind of depends on you and your body and how you take care of it.
Taking care
of it's a big part of it. Eating right, supplements right, stretching, you just gotta take care
all
of yourself.
All that stuff. Yeah, absolutely. Now, do you ever get sick of traveling? I mean, all you're doing is just traveling. You're in one city and another, and you're wrestling with some other dude and wrestling another. You never know what freaking city you're in before you know it. You know, you ever get sick of just your traveling?
No, I don't ever get sick of it, but it does get hard. You know, I love what I do, and I wouldn't trade it for anything.
Yeah.
But it does get hard, especially when you have a wife at home, and, you know, she wants you to come home, and 6 days on the road, home for two, and 6 days on the road again, you know, it can get a little rough, but it's what we do.
Yeah. What are some of the things about professional wrestling that you don't like? Anything that you don't like that's just like, are the fans too crazy, or is it just, you know...
I love every minute of it.
Is every minute of it?
Love every minute of it.
That's killer, man.
Absolutely.
Do you have any people that you wrestle against in TNA wrestling that you don't freaking like them? Like, I know you don't like them on the ring, right? You know, obviously, it's TV, it's wrestling, you're not supposed to like each other. But I'm talking like, you personally don't freaking like this person, and... at all, and you gotta freaking wrestle them. Have you ever been put in that type of situation?
Nope.
Never?
Nope. I've been never, you know, it's like an old fashioned bar fight. You go out there, we do our thing, we're professionals about it, end of story.
That's it.
Come back and shake it out if you need to.
Man, absolutely. Well, I know we had Jesse Sorensen in the studio. Jesse broke his neck, man, was pretty much a quadriplegic for about 24 hours. He came out of it. Any major injuries that like set you back for a while?
No, nothing. I've been fortunate. You know, it was an unfortunate situation with Jesse, but I'm glad, you know, he pulled through. And he, you know, stronger and harder and faster than anybody ever thought that he would. So, you know, he's very fortunate. I've been fortunate enough not to have to.
Never that happened
to me. So, you know, I hope it stays that way.
Yeah. Now listen, when you're on the ring. Right, you're in the ring, you go up on the ropes. Something's gotta be going through your mind, like when you guys do these freaking backflips and crap off the ropes. I mean, how freaking scary is that crap, dude?
Yeah.
I don't see myself, you can call me a puss, whatever you want. I don't see myself doing a freaking double backflip off of freaking ropes landing on somebody, dude. Just not my thing, you know what I'm saying?
Some people are really good at certain things. Up on the ropes and backflipping, I'm not one of them.
That's not your thing either, huh?
I'm going to try to keep myself on the ground.
See, that's how I am, man.
I get up there and do some stuff, but backflipping is not one of them. But, you know, you get up there and I don't think about it when I'm doing, you know, you got the adrenaline pumping, you got the crowd going, you got the light, you got everything. You just do it, man. You just go. You know, you're almost doing it before you even realize what's going on.
Yeah. Who were some of your favorite wrestlers when you were growing up?
Oh, man. I love watching the Road Warriors. Those are my
favorite. Yeah, Road Warriors, back absolutely. In the day. Now, I'm a Tampa boy, so I mean, we had a whole ton of wrestlers around here.
Absolutely.
I used to go to a gym, man. We had Hulk Hogan, we had Macho Man, we had Bushwhackers. I'm still friends with one of the Bushwhackers.
I saw him a little while ago.
Yep, we had Brutus the Beefcake Barber, we had Greg the Hammer Valentine, all types of wrestlers. We would come to our gym. The show, what was his name? Big Show or something like that. Yeah, all of them dudes. So, who were some of your favorites? You like the Road Warrior?
I was Ricky the Dragon Steamboat was always one of my favorite guys to watch.
Okay. Macho Man, dude. He was.
I got a lot of the Macho Man.
Yeah, dude. He was killer,
man. Absolutely.
Yeah, I caught a couple workouts with the Macho Man. He was freaking super cool, dude.
Very cool.
Yeah. Talk just like that too.
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely. Kurt Hennig was one of my favorite guys to watch.
But Hogan. Now you're friends with Hogan, aren't you?
Yeah. Yep, we're good friends. Yep.
You guys train in the same gym, right?
We do.
You and Hulk Hogan?
Every once in a while, I still learn a thing or two from you. From them. From the old school workouts.
There you go. Well, last thing here, man. We got some viewers. Check this out. Look at this camera, man. Deep inside the internet, into the land of YouTube. You see that?
I see that.
There's some people out there watching this. They are wrestling fans. Wrestling fans. And there's some people that want to be professional wrestlers one day. Dude, give them, please, some type of motivation, some kind of encouragement on their journey trying to become a professional wrestler.
Absolutely, and as I said earlier, it takes heart and it takes determination. If you got those two things and a never say never and a never say quit attitude, that's the best advice I can give you. You're gonna have a rocky road, it's gonna be hard, it's gonna be painful, it's gonna be brutal. But if you keep with it, stick with it, it'll pay off, I promise. Just keep fighting. Don't give up.
Awesome. Hey, man, what's up with these shirts, man? Tell me about these shirts.
This is my line, One Bad Cat.
One Bad Cat. Yeah, that's pretty. Oh, look at this.
Baby.
Homeboy got a tattoo on him. He's got the shirts. What do you got, like hats and all that stuff, too?
Shirts, hats, beanies, sweatshirts.
All that.
Ladies.
Now, where? Ladies stuff, listen, where can they order One Bad Cat clothing?
Check us out at onebadcat.com. And you can follow us on Twitter at OneBadCatInc.
All right, guys, listen, don't forget to subscribe. Give me a like. Thank you very much, Garrett.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Cool. Tune in next time.
Thank you, guys.